Hi, welcome to the Macworld video. I'm Chris Breen. You know, I love music. I love filling my ears with it and then adding some more. And recently, I've acquired a hunk of gear that allows me to do that. It's called the Sonos Multi-Room Music System. Recently, Sonos has released a new CR200 hardware controller that makes using that system even easier. In the next few minutes, I'll take you on a tour of that system. The Sonos Multi-Room Music System works over your local network, streaming music not only from your computer, but also from online music services such as Pandora, Last.fm, Rhapsody, and Napster. It also works with internet and terrestrial radio stations. Music streamed to a Sonos Zone Player or Zone Bridge is then distributed to other Sonos units around your house. In my case, I have a Zone Player 120, which houses an amplifier, a Zone Player 90, which is an unamplified unit that requires that you attach powered speakers to it, a Zone Bridge, which attaches to my router and distributes audio to the Zone Players, and the CR200 controller for choosing and organizing the music the Zone Players play. My setup is pretty easy. Just plug an Ethernet cable into the Zone Bridge, attach unpowered speakers to the Zone Player 120, attach the powered speakers to the Zone Player 90, and then use the Sonos Desktop Controller application on my Mac to configure the units as well as direct them to the music on my computers and the online music services I subscribe to. Once you do this, you can stream music throughout your house. But why drop $1,000 on something like that when you can get a few Airport Express base stations, connect them to iTunes, and then listen to music that way? That's a perfectly fine option, particularly if you have an iPod Touch or iPhone running Apple's remote application, which allows you to control your music on the go. Otherwise, you have to sit at your computer to do it. One of the Sonos system's major advantages is that you can stream different music to each Zone Player, thus the use of the word zone. So, if I want, my wife can listen to folk music in the living room, I can listen to power pop in my office, and if I had another Zone Player, my daughter could listen to Linkin Park in her bedroom. Also, iTunes and the remote app keep you boxed into iTunes. If you want to use other music services like Pandora, you'll need a utility such as Rogue Amoeba's Airfoil 3 to stream other content to the Airport Express. Unlike an Airport Express, the Sonos system doesn't care where you keep your content. You can create a playlist or a queue that mixes both content from your iTunes library as well as from a service such as Rhapsody or Napster, ask it to play, and it just plays. You don't need to muck with settings and say, no, this is here and that's there. It just happens automatically.
You have three ways to control the Sonos: the Sonos Desktop Controller application, the free Sonos Controller app for the iPhone and iPod Touch, and the new CR200 controller. They all give you the same basic level of control. Obviously, the iPhone app and CR200 are the most convenient because you control your music from anywhere. The iPhone app and CR200 controllers are really similar. The music menu screens are presented differently, but the hierarchical navigation is pretty much the same. The CR200 is snappier than the iPhone app, has better battery life, and it's convenient because it's always ready to go. You don't need to quit out of another application before you can use it. To control your Sonos gear, just select a zone by tapping the Zone button, access the music menu, and choose a source. In this case, I'm playing something from my iTunes library. Here I'm accessing Rhapsody, using the search function. With it, I can look for a favorite artist, album, or track. I can then play those tracks immediately or add them to the queue. Once in the queue, I can edit their order as well as delete them. Pandora and Last.fm work much like they do on your computer. Just select one of your stations or choose Quick Mix and music pours from your Sonos. You can rate tracks Pandora plays as well as tap the info button to create new stations and bookmark tracks and artists. Sonos Zone Players also include a line-in jack so you can attach a device such as a CD player and stream the music it plays to any other Zone Players on your network. If you have a Zone player in your bedroom, you might want to take advantage of its alarm feature. With it, you can tell the Sonos when you want it to kick in and what you want it to play. Choosing a Sonos playlist, an iTunes playlist that you've imported, Pandora Radio, Rhapsody content, or a favorite radio station. And as I mentioned earlier, speaking of radio, yes, the Sonos system can play terrestrial and internet radio as well.
And that's a rundown on the Sonos multi-room music system. You can purchase a bundle that includes the Zone Player 120, the Zone Player 90, and the CR200 controller for $1,000. I understand this is not an inexpensive proposition, but I will say of all the music gadgets I own, and that includes my iPod and my iPhone, I use the Sonos system more than any other. Thanks for joining me. See you around.